This is going to be awkward. Okay, I want to talk about Eric Weinstein because people keep asking me to talk about Eric Weinstein. And I think it's somewhat insulting, really. They should be asking him to talk about me. More seriously, I watched this recent episode of Eric and Sean Carroll on Piers Morgan and read the comments from all those who piled on afterwards. And boy, was this ugly. I can't believe the fucking hypocrisy of these people. So that's why I finally want to talk about Eric. I've known Eric for almost 20 years. He's a good guy. If you take away one thing from this video, let it be that Sabine said Eric's a good and fairly normal person, in contrast to a lot of others who think it's okay to shit on people they know nothing about. I've seen an enormous amount of hate thrown at Eric that he doesn't deserve. In case you managed to miss Carol Gate, I don't want you to get away with it, so let me fill you in. Eric has a theory of everything, like all other people I know. His is called geometric unity. He's been talking about this already 20 years ago. It's his life's work, basically. In 2021, he wrote up some notes about it. Physicists were not particularly impressed. I never looked into this in any detail because I'm not interested in unification ideas and I think it's a waste of time. I don't see why the fundamental forces of nature have to be unified and I have no idea why so many people are obsessed with this, but I want to try and give you a brief idea what this is all about. The standard model of particle physics is based on symmetries, and these symmetries are defined by groups. The ones for the standard model are called U1, SU2 and SU3. Don't worry if you don't know what this is or how it works. The only thing that matters is that 1, 2 and 3 are fairly small numbers. Now, what you can do is you can look for a bigger group. One with a bigger number, basically, and try to find the standard model in this group. If you manage to do this, you have a candidate for a unified theory. The problem is there are infinitely many groups and almost all of them contain the standard model groups. Consequently, physicists have proposed thousands of these unified theories. Since these large groups usually contain more than just the standard model, unified theories all predict new particles. And then you have to come up with some reason for why we haven't seen these new particles or postulate that they make up dark matter and the usual stuff that hasn't worked since the 1980s. This hopefully explains why I'm unexcited about yet another unified something. We have too many of those already, it hasn't worked for 40 years, and there's no evidence supporting any of this. Eric sees this differently. He thinks that no one has yet done it the right way, which is possible, and if this is how he wants to spend his life, that's fine with me. I won't attempt to explain exactly what Eric's doing, I'll just try to give you my stupid girl summary. Einstein's theories work with a four-dimensional space-time. The space-time's described by what's called the metric tensor that measures the relations between directions. So the metric tensor has 4 times 4 equals 16 entries. But it's a metric, so only 10 of those entries are different. You can just ignore all the words that you didn't understand. The number 10 is the relevant part. It just so happens that one of the first and probably most studied groups for unification is SO10, and that also has a 10 in it. So Eric postulates that these two tens are somehow related. Basically, he doubles the gravitational part of Einstein's theory and takes the one version to be the generator of this group that gives you something like SO10. Devil's in the details. By this I mean that, in all fairness, Eric's idea is a bit sketchy. But honestly, I don't doubt that with some effort you can somehow make the maths work out. So this is roughly what Eric's working on, I believe. It's all fairly unremarkable, really. The mathematics is pretty close to what physicists are using already, and it's totally in line with all the other nonsense that physicists in the foundations now work on. But for reasons I don't quite understand, a lot of people find this all very interesting, which is how Eric ended up on Piers Morgan with Sean Carroll. and this happened.
The good news is I have read Eric's paper. Here it is. I actually have it here, right here. And it's worse than you would think. You know, it's not serious. It's a dog ate my homework kind of thing. If you have a dark matter thing, if you have a dark matter prediction, if you have a dark energy prediction, I want to see a plot in the paper. I want to see redshift versus distance. I want to see a calculation of a relic abundance so I can figure out how much dark matter is supposed to be. If you do that, people will pay attention to the theory. It's very possible.
Sean, first of all, how dare you? Second of all, if you're going to go by the
read your paper?
No, Sean, how dare you cast shade and aspersions of the kind that I wouldn't seek to cast on you, but I will now. I'm not seeking your favor, nor do I need to seek your approval. As you know, you failed to gain tenure.
I think one has to give credits to Sean that he agreed to do this because the vast majority of physicists would have chickened out. And honestly, Sean did a pretty good job. Yes, Eric's work is far from complete. Yes, he doesn't have a Lagrangian and he hasn't actually solved any problem and he hasn't explained how anomaly cancellation works in other than some hand-wavy, there ought to be new particles somewhere. He doesn't have tangible predictions. But then, Eric's only one person who wrote up some notes. If he had wasted some millions of tax money on hiring postdocs and writing papers about it, then he could have easily papered over these shortcomings, just like everyone else in that area. And this is why this pisses me off so much. Sean totally knows that most of his colleagues work on similarly flaky stuff. It's just been covered up by more working hours. The literature's full of papers without proper predictions, without Lagrangians, ill-defined operators, or problems that will be solved in some future work that never comes. Sean knows that. Everyone in the damn field knows that. But normally, no one's saying anything about it because they're all tied up in the same scam. Unless the person who comes up with the idea is Eric Weinstein, in which case it's suddenly hugely offensive and everyone starts yelling. Well, Sean, why don't you talk for a little bit about all these supposed ADS-CFD predictions for condensed matter, this or that, which were supposed to revolutionize superconductivity? Whatever happened to that? And just exactly how is string theory defined anyway? Did they actually ever solve the problem of quantum gravity? Like, did they ever prove it's finite? What Calabi-Yau manifold are we talking about again? Or how about loop quantum gravity? Do they have a well-defined Hamiltonian? Where is the classical limit? And these are areas in which thousands of people have spent decades and billions of dollars. Why aren't you talking about this rather than crapping on Eric, who's one single person and at least trying to do something new? They say that they want people to think outside the box. But if someone actually does it, they're like, nah, not this way. You don't talk like us. You don't walk like us. We don't like the people you play with. Therefore, we'll not look at your ideas. This is the sorry state of theoretical physics now. And then you get all these people piling onto each hate parade. The groupthink is so thick. Like, they all think it's fine to hate on Eric because they expect their colleagues to cheer on them for doing so. And those who think that maybe Eric's idea isn't so bad, keep their mouth shut. Like with this recent episode about Perimeter Institute. In his Morgan appearance, Eric said vaguely he's been visiting some physics institute and giving a talk. Someone leaked later that this was Perimeter Institute and spread a rumor that they didn't want to be associated with him and that they made a deal that Eric would donate money in return. This is all bullshit, and if they'd stopped and thought for a second, they'd have known it's bullshit. This just isn't how seminar invitations work. Also, let me tell you that when I give talks, I frequently do not mention publicly where I'm going for reasons. I also knew that Eric's been giving a bunch of physics lectures in the past years about which you find nothing online, presumably also for reasons. The story from Perimeter Institute is, to my understanding, that the person who invited him feared for their career. This tells you how sick this entire community is, that people are afraid to do as much as express interest in a new theory. Then there's Brian Keating, who deserves credit for not chickening out and for standing with Eric, even though that made people crap on Brian too. Then there's Kurt Jaimungo, who courageously published a very long video about Eric's theory and also interviewed Eric, which led to this following exchange.
I haven't seen such novel ideas from a single theory, from a single person, sorry, ever. And I don't know if anyone else will tell you this, but what you've done is remarkable, man.
I don't even know how to be with that, to be honest. Look. Thank you.
And again, you know, I saw people jump on Kurt and criticizing him just for talking to Eric. But, you know, Kurt is right. It's remarkable. Eric's idea is as remarkable as the ideas of thousands of other people, each of whom has spent years and years of their life on it and whom you've never heard anything about. In any case, I think what's really happening here is that a lot of people who work in the foundations of physics are very afraid that Eric is exposing how rotten their entire field is. This is why they're trying hard to discredit him. But the truth is that Eric's idea isn't any better or worse than all the other crap they're working on. The only difference is that he hasn't wasted as much of your tax money on it. That's it for today. No, there's no sponsor on this video because I don't want to be accused of monetizing a friendship, but please check out my Patreon. Thanks for watching.